Item number, SCP-3999-J. Object class, Keter. Special containment procedures. SCP-3999-J is to be contained at Site 42 in Specialized Containment Wing R. On the 25th of June, 2014, researcher James Talloran volunteered to dedicate around-the-clock support to containing SCP-3999-J. As such, researcher Talloran has been forbidden from leaving Containment Wing R under threat of lethal force. All visiting researchers to Containment Wing R must be cleared by researcher Talloran. Additionally, Containment Wing R has the following requirements. The enclosure must be cleaned daily. All organic matter is to be collected and disposed of. Soiled linens are to be washed, and all surfaces of the primary containment enclosure must be sanitized. Supplies and provisions are to be restocked daily. Researcher Talloran should be consulted every morning to determine any necessary special provisions or supplies for that day. Crews are to remain on hand at all times to service and fuel all vehicles in the containment track. Mobile Task Force Lambda 3, codename Bounty Hunters, has been established to contain SCP-3999-J. In addition to standard armaments, Mobile Task Force Lambda 3 is to maintain an arsenal of eye-combat laser guns. The indoor containment pool must be kept at 29 degrees Celsius, while the auxiliary containment tub must be kept at 40 degrees Celsius. Description: SCP-3999-J is an entity capable of causing an XK end-of-the-world scenario at will. Accounts of its appearance are inconsistent, and it is believed that it can shapeshift. It can appear as a half-bear, half-man creature with many tentacles coming out of its back, or a nondescript human. Originally, it made stubborn demands for food and large sums of US currency, but researcher Talloran has devised several containment strategies to keep its effects at bay. SCP-3999-J's secondary effect is an anti-mimetic field that erases all memories of itself from anyone who views it. This effect occurs in real time, so the entity appears invisible. However, researcher Talloran is immune to the anti-mimetic effect. Studies are underway to determine researcher Talloran's unique immunity to SCP-3999-J. Update, 5th of January, 2015. Guest researchers Candy Madison, Jackie Love, and Emma Angel have agreed to indefinitely assist researcher Talloran in containment efforts. Update, 5th of March, 2015. Guest researchers Mitch Talloran and Trevor Mason were both confirmed to be immune to SCP-3999-J, and have agreed to indefinitely assist researcher James Talloran in containment efforts. Update 19th of April 2015. Guest researchers Alexa Cuddy and Ivy Hart have agreed to indefinitely assist researcher Talloran in containment efforts. Document 3999-J-1-3. These transcripts document the first known encounter with SCP-3999-J.
Voices identified. Front desk staff, researcher Talloran.
Hello, front desk?
Yes, this is James Talloran. Can you ask the cafeteria to send up a cheeseburger and fries to my desk? I'm working late tonight.
Let me check. No, sorry, you're not on the list. Only essential containment personnel can request meal delivery.
Oh, I see. Well, I've got a Keter entity here, and I need a cheeseburger and fries to contain it.
Whatever, take it up with containment. Extension 3333.
Voices identified. Containment staff, researcher Talloran.
Hello, containment, what's your emergency?
Yes, this is researcher Talloran. I'm in room 402B, and I've got a, Keter entity here, and I need a cheeseburger and fries to contain it.
Right away, sir. Cheeseburger and fries stat. What is the designation of the Keter entity?
It's new, and it wants a Coke also.
Yes, sir. Stay where you are, sir. Do not move. Do not engage the Keter entity. Wait for containment forces to arrive.
Voices identified. Mobile Task Force Delta 1. Researcher Talloran.
Sir, do not move! Where is the Keter entity?
It's right there in the corner. What, can't you see it?
Keter entity, stand down!
It says to put the food on my desk.
626, present the package!
Sir, yes sir.
Oh, it disappeared. Great job, Mobile Task Force.
Document 3999-J-2713. This transcript documents the latest information on SCP-3999-J's containment.
Voices identified. Director Lycus, researcher Talloran.
James, it's a great thing you do. I don't know how you can handle it, keeping that thing at bay all these years.
It's no trouble, Director, really.
How are the latest containment procedures working?
Oh, they're great. The containment course was really a great idea. By driving it around at high speeds in those supercars, we're able to really just, contain the hell out of 3999.
Does this mean the old containment procedures are no longer necessary? You don't need the pool or the containment buffet anymore?
No, sir. Not at all, sir. Those are still absolutely, absolutely necessary. I mean, the cars only work on it for so long, sir. It adapts to them quickly, you know? And only by wrestling with it into that pool with my fellow researchers can we really, you know, keep it contained. And the buffet, I mean, 3999 wants like 5 or 6 times a day, so we need to keep that.
Roger that. So all of your previous containment procedures are still effective?
Yeah. But listen, you know the bar by the pool? 3999, I think he's adapting the selection there. I was hoping to restock with some different varieties.
Absolutely, I'll approve it. Anything else?
Yeah, I'll be putting in another order for Xbox games. 3999 has adapted to all of those also.
Of course.
Hey, can we cut this short? I gotta run. I need to go, oversee Candy and Alexa.
Godspeed to you.
Update. 5th of August, 2017. SCP-3999-J has demonstrated the ability to mimetically affect remote individuals, causing them to hallucinate. This typically manifests as illusions of researcher Talloran entering and leaving the containment facility. It also manifested remotely when one off-duty scientist hallucinated researcher Talloran entering a casino, and later that day when another staff member hallucinated seeing researcher Talloran purchasing an automobile. On that same occasion, an entire team of containment personnel hallucinated picking up researcher Talloran at a hospital after they hallucinated him drunkenly text them that he had crashed into a parked car. Researcher Talloran's investigation into this new ability is ongoing.